Hello, I'm Robert. Welcome back to our classes. Today I think we're going to do a nice scene with lots of clouds. Try to get a nice sky into this. We're going to concentrate on the sky with a lot of cloud movement. Maybe have a mountain, a little bit of lake action down here, some shrubs and trees along the side. So that's what our intention will be when we do this. Let me take my little guy down. And let me move Bob out of the way. And I will show you what I have as far as colors. I have some titanium white, Indian yellow. I have a mixture here of alizarin crimson and sap green. I have some Prussian blue here, and I have another mixture here of the dark, which will be another alizarin and sap green. I have some sap green over here, sap green. So we'll work with those colors, and we'll begin by working in the upper part of the sky here. Before I did this, of course, I've got this very, very thin coat, an even coat, of liquid clear. That'll allow us to get our paints in there. It takes less paints when we do that. We're mixing on the canvas rather than on our palette. So it gives us a nice, easy method for us to proceed. So I've got a nice, thin, even coat. Again, it has to be very, very thin. You're almost working it into the fibers of the brush. No heavy coat. Too much of the liquid white is not good. Too little is not good either. So you got to have it just about right. The way to tell that is once you put it on your very, very thin coat, as you touch it with your finger, and if you can see your fingerprint in there, then that should be just about right. If not, take a clean brush and stroke it some more and get a little bit more of it off. Okay? So, we're going to start out with this nice Indian yellow. This will give us a nice vibrant undercoat. Again, we're kind of conditioning the canvas for our detail work. So, I've got a very, very little amount a paint on the end of that. And I'll start with my crisscross strokes. I'm going to really apply a lot of pressure. Start at the top, work down, really working it into the fabric of the canvas. And not too much, this is just our undercoat. And as it goes down, as I said, it lightens up. And that's the way it should be. Darker on the top, lighter on the bottom. Add a little bit more in the corners. I make the corners a little bit darker, so throw your eye down into it. This will drive your eye to the center of the painting. Okay, so I have that nice first value in here. Now I'm going to come in here with just a little bit of my mixture of the alizarin crimson. It has a little bit of sap in there. Just a very little minimum amount. Start at the top, work it on down, blend it a little bit into the, work it a little bit into the Indian yellow. Really hitting the fibers, lots of pressure. We want this paint to sink into those grooves. So I'm applying a lot of pressure on this. Little X's. And then I'm going to, on the left-hand side, I'm going to get a little bit of a dark mixture of phthalo blue and crimson, or lizen crimson. And have just a little touch of that. Tap it into the ends of the brush. And I'm just going to make some X's over here. This gives us a nice little bit of a gray color. A very pretty gray color. Really top to bottom. I'm going to clean my brush. Use that in odorless paint thinner. Then I have a little bit of a post down here in a box that I can bring it across to get the splatter out of it. Get the paint. So it should be nice and dry, the brush. And now I'm just going to blend across a little bit to get it even. And I think I'm going to put a little bit of, have a little bit of water in here. So I'm going to take the same colors that I have up here, and they're going to be down in the water too. So I'm going to bring some of those same colors, which is the Indian yellow. Bit of the alizarin and the green combination, sap green. Then we'll take our gray mix too. Put that across here. Whatever's on top should be in the bottom. I'm going to clean that brush again. Blend this out. Just soften it up. So this is kind of just prepping the canvas for our next steps. So we have a nice, almost pastelish sky in there. So I count down. I'm going to clean the brush again. And then we're going to switch to our fan brush. So I'm going to take this fan brush. I'm going to bring it into our titanium white. Pull that out. Both sides, nice and thick. And I'm going to add just a touch of that Indian yellow to it. Just a hint of that. As I said, I want that brush, lots of paint on there. And then I'm just going to take almost with the corner of it and plunge it in there and then twirl it. So I'm just applying some color. Now you can't go back into that without washing it because it gets dirty. So I have to clean it again. And we'll pick up some more. And we'll add some more cloud over here. I don't want to keep on grinding it at the same spot, or else I'll just get a cotton ball. Clean it again. Pick up a little bit more paint. And a little bit more up here. Clean it once again. I'm going to add some more titanium white, and this time I'm going to add just a touch of the red mix that we made. A little pinkish color, and I'll come up here. Plow it in there. Yeah, I'm spreading those bristles out. Maybe a little bit down here. In the brush. Maybe a little bit into here. All right, we'll clean our brushing a little bit more. Then I'm going to take clean. Dry brush. This, in this case, it's a 2-inch brush. And I'm just going to take the bottoms and gently, at the bottom only, just a few hairs touching it, blend in. If you get a little bit of excess paint here, before you blend, you can just go across here and kind of scrape off all the excess. Makes it easier for us to blend. So again, clean dry brush. Little circular motions and kind of lift. Very soft, barely touching. So you have a nice full clouded light sky. Now I'm going to clean the brush again. And we'll come back here with our green alizarin crimson mix. I'm going to take the palette knife. I'm going to cut just a little roll of paint at the very end of that, and we'll add in our mountain range. So you see the knife has kind of a point to it. It's almost like the top of a mountain. So you can kind of say that that's the top of your mountain. I'll put this in. I'm pressing very hard on this. Working into the canvas. I don't want any excess paint on it because this is just the base coat again. We're going to be adding some highlights to it. Rolling, scraping out all the excess paint. Then I'm going to take my 1-inch brush and just pull color out. Here. Maybe I'll add another little peak over here. this out. Clean the brush. Now I'm going to take, for highlights, I'm going to take this Prussian blue. Mix up a little bit of a titanium white, and then I'm going to take more of the titanium white, mix that down here to get another light color of that blue or blue-gray combination. So I have two different values here. I'm going to take the darker one. I'm going to cut across, get that little roll of paint at the end, and we're going to just touch the side of there. The sun's coming this way, so we'll touch this way and just barely touch. Barely touch. Let it break for you. Maybe a little bit on this side. And some over here. Then we're going to come back. It's a titanium white. With this lighter color, we get the lighter color with a little roll paint at the end of it, and I'm barely going to touch this. Go over it. So add that second value to it. Barely touching the canvas. I'm letting the paint pull. Okay, so that gives me a couple of values in there. Then I'm going to take more straight titanium white. Cutting across that little roll of paint at the end. Barely touching, making a break. To this side. Getting that little gold paint on there. Just tying it right. So then I could come up here with a little row of the dark mix and just touch a few areas. Just to get another value in there. Okay, so I'm going to clean the knife off. Get this clean 1-inch brush. And I'm just going to come down here and tap the bottom rather hard so we can get some mist. Bit of fog at the bottom. Same angle to put the paints on with. So you have a little bit of fog at the bottom. Now I'm going to come in here. I'm going to take my dark colors and just drag that 1-inch brush across the dark colors, and it makes it have one edge that becomes a little bit rounded. So that rounded edge, you just punch and press and out, press out. Press and out. give some indication of some foliage. This is the back of the trees. Here, another tree over here. Maybe this one will go even higher. And when it gets a little more dark, more dark out here, because it has to have a lot of paint in it. I'm just pressing and lifting up here. We're going to highlight these trees in a minute, but I have to have the dark laid out so we can add the light. Down a little bit. Lots of dark. Down here on the right a little bit. Bit more up top. Okay. So we don't have all the darks in here. So I'm going to clean my brush. Going to start adding some nice highlights on this. So we're going to take some titanium white. We'll grab, pull that out. We'll add some green to it. Maybe a little bit of the Indian yellow. We're tapping it into the end. Then I'm going to dip it into my liquid white. Liquid white will thin it down. Okay. And we'll just tap in a little bit of color. It over here. You need the liquid white that will thin this down. And as we said, a thin paint will stick to a thick paint. Grab a little bit of more of that Indian yellow. I'll tap that into the brush. You get another value. More yellow value down here. Just tapping and pulling out. Tapping mostly with the end of that brush. Mixing up various combinations of blue, green, maybe even our red combination. All the colors that you mixed. The key is to get that liquid white on the end. Clean the brush out a little bit. yellow to this. We'll introduce CAD yellow. Pull it out. More white. The end of the corner of the brush. Tapping the color in. You choose the colors that you want. Again, we're just using the corner of the brush. The brush again. More yellow. Base foliage down. push it to a band brush, just add some details to it. I'm building up different values in here. We'll take a green brush again, so I'll clean this one out. And we're going to pull straight down in here. Straight down, we're going to build some reflections. Palette knife. Get across the shoreline. Scrape up some trunks, stems for our tree. Just pulling straight up. Scrape in some. or water lines. Our tree limbs. Shoreline back here. And then we'll just take off. I like to have, as I mentioned earlier, I like to have white border around it, which you don't need, you don't want it. Okay. So there you have it. That's our mountain. A little bit of a pastel. You know, it's nice and pastel. It's close to watercolors. A lot of values into it. The key, again, that we did, one of the keys to this one is we took the color, we made the blended colors, and then we dipped it into the liquid white so it transposed onto the heavier paint easier. So remember that when you do it. And that'll enhance your painting, make it a little bit easier. So again, I think this is a nice kind of soft painting. It's enjoyable to do. It's a nice summer day. So hope you enjoyed it. Take care.